I sense there's something in the wind that feels like tragedy.
Right, I'm here. What?
Josh is gone. I found his phone. This is what he finds. What? What is it? What is it?
It's just nothing. It's nothing.
What? Dude, this could mean something. Brett, what's going on?
I had this weird dream, okay? It was insane. It was, remember that day that we were supposed to do our parade?
Yeah?
We never actually did. Because I had this dream, this like vision while I was waiting in the car for Josh to get in. And we went to pick you up and then Josh disappeared. And then we saw this weird person and he like blinked towards us at like an amazing speed. And then he took us all eventually. And then the last thing I remember was he pounding on the door trying to get into the car. And then I woke up and Josh was there, so I figured I'd just take Josh home and we'd forget about the whole thing and maybe it wouldn't happen.
No wonder you didn't come to my house.
Yeah.
What could this mean? We should tell somebody about this.
Yeah, like who's gonna believe us? I have a weird dream, like Final Destination crap. That's gonna be like totally believable.
You never know, it could happen! They took my brother! Alright, you know what? Wait a minute, don't you know a couple people that can help us?
I mean, maybe one of my friends from back in college, but that's about all I know.
Well, call them up. I'm not leaving your house until I find my brother.
Maybe I'm the one. Hello?
Oh, hello?
This is Detective Duffy.
Oh.
You say you got a paranormal problem?
Oh.
Well, what kind?
Slender Man.
Slender Man, you say?
Oh.
Huh. Well, where do you live? Okay, I'll be there soon.
Oh.
Bye.
Yes, Josh? Yes, this is me. Okay, so you're almost over here? Okay. Thanks. Corrine. He's almost here.
What?
He's almost here.
I don't care.
Okay.
Wait a second.
Well, he'll be here soon.
Hello, is this the Jones residence?
Yes.
Professor Duffield.
Nice to meet you.
So, tell me again, what's your pro... Hello, what are you doing creeping over there?
That's Josh's...
You look a lot like my brother.
Do I?
Josh Duffield?
Oh, he must be a distant cousin, I think. I think I may have met him once.
You look exactly like him, I swear.
Well, everyone does have their twin.
Yes.
Whether related or not. But anyways... So, tell me again, what seems to be your problem?
Oh, you see, it's this thing. I don't know how to explain it. We were going to go to this movie. I had picked up Josh at his house. While I was sitting there, I must have dozed off or something. So I had this weird, vivid dream like it was actually happening. And in my dream, we had actually picked Josh up and went over to Prim's house, and that's when everything went wrong.
Hmm.
And we found this weird type of circle. 2 slash marks.
What do you say?
On his phone.
Oh, now I know who you're talking about. Oh yeah, he. Oh, I know. I remember Josh. We had to like Skype each other, and because he needed help with something at college at a Central Ohio Technical, whatever. But anyways, I digress. So, I think I've seen this symbol before.
I saw it too. It was when I was having the dream. Josh was the first to go. When he left, he left behind that on a paper covered with blood.
Oh, yes. He's like, you got an enderman.
Enderman?
Yeah, an enderman.
I thought we had a Slenderman.
Well, Slenderman is a form of enderman.
Is there any way to find it?
Well, for one, it's a he, due to the suit. Because basically, the Slenderman is a being who, as far as we know, has no face, wears a black fedora, like me, and wears a blue suit with the red tie and white shirt, and he's very, very tall. It's like, he's probably twice my height, maybe.
That thing has my brother?
Well, unless that's just some effed up prank, I'd say yes. But then again, now that I mention it being a prank, it might be because normally his circular X note is on a piece of paper. It's normally not on phones like that. I mean, normally the Slender Man just takes his victims and the rest is history. Why would he, like, pick Josh's pocket and go to his draw app to draw that?
Because he knows what I saw. Maybe. He knows that Josh was the first to go in my dream. Ew. And he knows what I saw when Josh was gone.
Well, Professor Josh, at your service. Yes, my name also happens to be Josh. Like I said, distant cousin. So,
what do you think we should do? Like, because I've never encountered anything. The last time we tried to do anything, it got us.
Well, one thing I would do is I would first watch yourselves, like, watch all around you, because it's like he could be like right behind that tree over there, for all we know. One good suggestion is to take a video camera with you, like maybe not actually have it with you going as you're walking along, but maybe just like have it on your side. And it's like if the Slender Man actually gets you before he grabs you, you throw the camera down, and then he'll take you. And so when someone comes and looks for you, they'll get the camera, and then they'll see the footage. And then we'll see if
Wouldn't
the Slender
Man... more people?
I know it sounds unethical, but in most cases, it's the only way to do it. I mean, you can't just say, Slender Man, come out, and there he is. Nah, he'll come at you at any time, when you least expect it. I just best watch yourselves.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And since this is a personal matter even to me, because I'm related to this victim, I won't charge you for anything.
You too much. You're the only family I got left. You know what? This whole Slender Man thing is getting ridiculous. If there's a Slender Man in the woods, let it take my life. I don't care about this world anymore. My brother is gone!
I don't know how my parents are going to take this.
I don't know either. I mean, we've searched everywhere. I mean, listen, huh?
But how does he just find people? Like, randomly. He's not there 1 second, and then all of a sudden he has a GPS on you.
It's not known. It's not like there's actual interviews in him. It's like, oh, Slender Man, so I just want to ask you some questions. No. Like, no.
How do you know so much about the Slender Man, then?
I'm an expert on paranormal activity. It's one of the newer classes at Hogwarts.
Yes, Hogwarts.
Yeah.
Just a certain person there is.
Well, there's not much to my class, because right now we're just like doing urban myths and. And funny enough, I was just teaching my students the other day about the Slender Man.
You mean Enderman?
Enderman, Slender Man.
Okay.
Whatever. Well, yeah. Where's Corrine?
That's a good question. She was over here on the steps a second ago.
You in my house?
Don't think so. It's locked. Corrine!
Corrine!
Okay, so the Slender Man is somewhere around here, I'm guessing.
We're in!
Corrine, where are you? Oh my god.
Holy crap.
Corrine! My god, Corrine. Where is she?
Corrine.
Oh my god, Josh, I think you came from this way.
No, that way.
No, this way.
No, that way.
No, this way. Oh. I'll trust you since you're a professional, but that's that.
Thank you.
What is it?
Another note.
Oh god, not again.
That's two now. This has gone far enough.
Exactly.
Last time, I thought it was just a dream.
I know, but Corrine was the second to go. She was in the passenger seat, which the Slenderman ripped open. I can't believe we heard that back then.
I know. I mean,
known
and everything. Look.
I know, again!
Oi!
Corrine! Oh, hey guys!
What are you doing?
But
can you, like, not shine that light?
Maybe it's not her.
Then who the bloody hell was screaming?
Could be the Slenderman in disguise. That could have been the real Corrine screaming.
What are you guys talking about?
Maybe. We just heard, like, a girl scream come from over there.
That was me. Because, you see, I found the spider in the, deep under the leaf.
No, you didn't, because we found the Slenderman sign.
Yeah, what? we found a note on a leaf over there.
What?
In blood.
Huh.
We heard you scream from over there.
I told you, spider.
Oh, yes,
I
the spider's off. Going to bite you and have enough brain power in that tiny head of its... to write a Slenderman.
Yeah.
I did not see a Slenderman. I told you. I found the spider and I acted and I ran off.
But how does this explain the... Maybe it's just a note from another attack.
Well, where were you earlier?
Well, I just walked down to those trees over there, that's all.
Because
I was so upset.
What did the spider look like? What did the spider look like?
It was blue and fuzzy.
Blue and fuzzy spider.
Okay.
I don't think that's native to North America. Blue fuzzy spiders.
They had black eyes. Yeah.
Blue fuzzy black eyed spider. I've never seen that in North America.
Those are rare in Europe.
Yes, but we're not in Europe.
Could have come.
Did you bring your spider with you?
No, but you people settled over here, so it must have come over, and it must be just a descendant from 100 years ago.
He is so like my brother.
Cousin.
I'm keeping my eye on you. I don't believe this.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I mean, I'm even a little suspicious.
I'll be up here.
No offense.
And die again.
Ability to see the truth in people, if they're telling the truth.
Yes, but people are good actors. You never really know if someone's lying. Well, I think...
Josh and Corrine, the only person that's left is me.
Well, Corrine's here.
She's here, but the lights aren't on. If you get what I'm saying.
Lights are on, but there's no one home. I see. I think we should take another look around over there. I'm sure something may turn up. I'm not just saying that note thing.
Don't even think we're going to find anything over here, I mean...
Well, at least I got more. Numos! Oh! Oh, bloody hell.
Josh!
What? Oi! You! Get back here!
You did promise you would get my brother back, right?
Should we drink vodka to create our problems, not to solve them?
This is sponsored by Flipovision.
Lipovision.
Flipovision in my nose.
Flipovision.
Flipovision.
Flipovision Halloween. The best Flipovision.
But Flipovision is more insane than insanity.
Watch it.